Come As You Are really personifies this record because it is the music I listen to. We're very true to that. This CD actually is a very personal CD for me. And I'm always definitely one to be an individualist, and I want to play my own music. I'm very much a writer, and one of the first songs that I wrote for this CD is called Come As You Are. And it seemed that, you know, throughout maybe the evolution of the record and the writing for it, that theme like kept coming back, kind of come as you are, be who you are. And that's really what I wanted. I wanted it to be from my heart, who I was. The recording of this record was very interesting from a few aspects. A, I used most of my friends. I really wanted it to be the people that I came up the ranks playing with, the people that I've been in the crazy dirty clubs in Los Angeles playing till 2 in the morning with, or the people that I grew up with in college writing songs and playing and experimenting. Matthew Hager, who produced it and co-wrote a lot of it with me, we've been best friends since college. We've played in each other's bands, we've written countless songs together, and we've just learned from each other through the years and developed. I got my dad on the record, which is awesome. I just think it's so fitting. It's funny, the whole vocal experience with me, it's always been an interesting journey. And now I think you go through a lifetime of finding yourself or being comfortable with who you are. On my first record, I sang one song and I thought it was awesome just to get out there and really express myself that way and not worry about respect or being an instrumentalist. I've proved myself with that, I feel. And I just want to express myself that way. So this record actually, in the writing of it, it came out that a few of the songs were vocals. And I felt incredibly comfortable with what we were writing. And it became such a part of the record that I just thought it was awesome to include. So hopefully people will like it as much as we did. Every Time is actually the first vocal song that we wrote for this CD. It's very pop influenced, and you know, of course I had to put some saxophone on there too. It's very special to me. You know, there's something for everyone on this CD. No matter which style you maybe lean towards, there's something that you're gonna like. Each song has its place in my heart, and each song was written at a different time for a different reason. One song I have to say that stands out to me is one of the vocal songs, and it's called I Can Remember. And it came together really beautifully. I had been going through, one of my friends had died recently, and it was a very close friend of mine who had been a road manager for a lot of us. And it was this amazingly beautiful and optimistic view of losing someone and going on with your life. And that's what the song was about. Farther from love. So there is something I haven't told you about the CD. There's a hidden track. And it's really fun. It was one of the songs that I co-wrote with Russell Ferrante, who is so amazing. I can't say enough about him, just as a human being and obviously as a writer and player. And we sat in a room and, you know, grand piano and just played off each other, and it's really just fast, furious, crazy, just really amazing. We really had a blast. So yeah, it's the track. You know what? I surround myself with my friends and my family, and that is so important to me. And I think that permeates every aspect of who I am. I'm pretty simple, pretty face value, and I think that that speaks in my music as well. I definitely don't try and pose to be anything I'm not. And hopefully there's an honesty there that you can hear in the music. But as far as life and love, I really love to surround myself with people I respect and people I like to be around. People that make me think, people that make me question things. My first CD, my first single was called Lucy's. And that's a place that I've hung out for years with a bunch of my friends. And it's a place we go and talk politics and talk about the state of the world and talk about how we could make it better or how we can't make it better or what we believe in, what we want in our lives, love and life, all of it. And that's really what's important to me.